I found myself in a fetal position on a hardwood crack house floor. I was desperate, frantic, paranoid, I was beaten down, but still ready to go once more. And just then a cockroach approached me, and he was desperately seeking a piece of meat or maybe just a crumb of bread. And well, he looked at me with disdain, and he sadly shook his cockroach hand. Well, the lady in the house, she woke shortly thereafter, and she said to me, she said, "Boy, heat you up some of my greens." She said, "Grab me a slice of bread to go with that, and while you're at it, boy, get you some of my ham and beans." See, as jacked up as that house lady was, and she was so jacked up, she still had a heart for my broken state, because you see, she could see in spite of me that it had been days, perhaps even weeks, since the last time that I had ate. You see, slowly, ever so slowly, I was dying, but man, I didn't give up. See, I didn't know, and I surely wouldn't have cared to God. My God, he had a master plan. Well, the greens, bread, the ham, and beans, it tasted like heaven on that day. So I chased them all down with a shot of royal crown, and that's when I heard the house lady pray. And when she prayed, she sang, "Lord, come by in my Lord. Somebody's dying, Lord. Lord, won't you come by here?" Well, the greens, the bread, the ham, and beans, the shot of crown, they all hit my belly, they made me warm. And that's when the devil's demons came and they hit me, stuck me, stung me like a desert storm. See, that dope boy came by, and our brother was so fresh and so fly, and he kept my pocket full of sand. He kept his mouth open wide so we could all see the smile he had inside, because that brother was sporting a platinum golden grin. Man, I couldn't even deliberate. I was like a puppet on a string. So I took that pocket full of sin, and once again I began to do my crack house thing. And at the sunrise I awoke to that same old cockroach, and he was hissing all up in my face. He turned away, he shook his cockroach booty, and I heard him say, he said, "Man, what a waste." Now looking back, I can't help but to think that the house of his spirit did this boy some good, because it's only by God's mercy and God's grace that I survived that neighborhood. See, a host of angels hovered over me. The angels for the lost, the hopeless, and the fools. Because only God, my God, could love a man who had broke so many rules. That was part one, and I felt the need to write part two sometime after that first one. You see, I rose up off that crack house floor, and I vowed to never ever return for more. And that same old cockroach approached me, and I crushed him at the door. And the house lady, she hollered after me. She said, "Boy, my you out, brought me a pack of Newports and a 40-ounce from the store." Yeah, right. Man, I jumped in my Honda Hootie. Beep, beep, see you later. And I was on my way. I turned the corner at Wittenberg and opened the street off into the sunset, annoyingly headed for a brand new way.